A partnership between Vancouver Island First Nations and natural gas supplier Fortis BC has produced the island's first natural gas storage facility. The project was the result of a decade's worth of planning, consulting, and finally constructing. A News reporter Steve Coulterman was at the top of Mount Hayes today for the grand opening.
Hundreds of people are at the top of Mount Hayes for the grand opening of a $200 million natural gas storage facility. It was 3 years in the making and is the first of its kind on Vancouver Island. Fortis BC says the new facility will provide customers on Vancouver Island and the Lower Mainland with a reliable supply of natural gas during the winter months when demand is high.
We transport gas to it in the summertime when we have lots of capacity on our pipeline system. We freeze the gas so that it comes into a liquefied form. Then in the wintertime, when we have very high loads on the island, when there's lots of people heating their homes and during the cold weather, this facility will actually send gas back out into our pipeline and help to add more capacity to the system and help meet the requirements during those peaking times in the winter.
More than 120 people worked on the construction of the facility, which will be operated by 12 full-time staff. The storage tank holds 1.5 billion cubic feet of liquefied natural gas. And although that sounds like a lot, Fortis says there is a need.
First of all, it starts with the need for a customer. It's a customer-driven need, and it's a good value from that perspective. It improves reliability. It gives us some on-island storage to back up our system through peak days. It gives us a way to manage some of the volatility in gas prices by having storage available. And so it's just a good site for that.
The facility is on the traditional territory of the Stamenis First Nation, and the First Nation has been an important partner during the facility's construction, with 25 of its own members working on it.
Fortis has come in, and they came to us to meet our council and our community, and I think it's been important that because most times corporations come in and don't consult with us, and that then it becomes a very not positive project, but this project has been positive.
The final nails have been hammered into the project, but that doesn't mean the partnership is over.
I think it will create revenue opportunities for our nation, and I think that's what we look for in any First Nation in British Columbia, is looking for an opportunity of revenue that we can put back into our communities to help our members in economic, you know, opportunities.
The facility is now open and in full operation, restoring natural gas throughout the summer to keep us warm throughout the winter. On Mount Hayes, Steve Coulterman, A News.